Hello everyone. Hello everyone. I hope you all are safe and sound. A big thank you to everyone who joined in for the webinar today. I am Jennifer Christian from STEMpedia. With me, I have the AI instructors, Mr. Ayusha and Mr. Shaleen Sharma, who will be taking you through the ride of AI and ML. To celebrate the Scratch Week 2021, which starts today, we have held you a webinar series of three-day live webinars, where on day one, we'll get started with programming, why it is important, and what are its uses. On day two, we'll move ahead to explore the artificial intelligence and the different AI techniques and their uses. Finally, on day three, we'll upskill with machine learning and learn how to train the machines. I would like to hand over the stage to Mr. Ayush now. Over to you.
So thank you, Jennifer. Thank you for introducing both of us. So I am Ayush, an AI instructor in STEMpedia, and I have along with me the Shaleen you can see at the center. And so today we will be taking you through the journey of the coding and then AI, then ML. And as you already know that we are the Scratch Week has started. So, but what exactly is a Scratch Week and why do we celebrate? So let me just give you a little bit of an idea of it. So basically we celebrate this Scratch Week for basically bringing out your imaginations, your creations, and after that, once you come up with the new projects and your creation and innovations, you can share that thing with us. Also, I would like to tell that generally this Scratch Week is themed to spark the project ideas and learning through creativity and coding at your home. So not taking much more of your time, let's start with today's webinar. So first of all, I will again welcome all the teachers, parents, and students for this webinar. So today we are going with the first webinar on this series of Scratch Week 2021. And I would request all of you to get downloaded with the PictoBlocks because we will be learning the coding with very Scratch in the PictoBlocks. So to explain you more on this, the first thing which comes up here is why exactly we need coding and AI. Okay, so if I directly ask you a question that why exactly there is a need of understanding a coding or learning a coding, so I will try to tell you the best 3 points which I can recollect. So first is it makes you an active contributor towards your society. So students, you might be seeing some problems around your society, around you, and you might have also been able to find a solution for it. But the things come up here that you are not able to put that into the action. So here, if you will be learning in coding, you will be learning in artificial intelligence. So there will be some of the problems which you can solve just by making the different codes and solving a real problem will definitely give you a high confidence. If I talk about the second point, you can see it here is a grow interest in technology. Many students might be in early age as of now, but in the future, you will be choosing one of your professional life out of being a teacher, being a musician, being an astronaut, scientist, anything, whatever you want. But trust me, you are gonna see a flavor of artificial intelligence and coding in your career opportunities coming in front of you. So why not to start early and win the race? So if you will be starting from in this age, your logical skills will develop in a great directions. And when till the time you will reach to your career options, it will become very much easy to pursue those things and bring your creations and innovations into it. So if I talk about that, what exactly is program? So because there are so many big words like artificial intelligence, machine learning, programming, but to understand all these things, there has to be a foundation. And the foundation word, if I suggest, is a program. So why not we start with this word and understand what exactly is program? So if I talk about program, program is a set of instructions that that a computer follows to complete a task. To explain you this in a much better way, so it's a simple example, like if I say you to bring a glass of water for me, so what you are going to do? So the first step, what you are going to take is you will be just standing up from your place, going to your kitchen, and then you'll take a glass of water and bring it to me. So you followed a certain set of instructions to complete a desired task. In the same way, if we desire to complete a task in computer or with our machines, in that case, we have to create a small program. And program, as I said, again, is a set of instructions. So the machine is going to follow those set of instructions which have been prepared by you and will give you the desired output, what you want. Now, in the programming, or I should say in the program, there are three basic steps. First is planning. The second is writing. And the third is testing and debugging. So to explain you these three steps, the first is planning, right? So of course, if you are coming up with a problem, you should have a plan to solve it. Only then there will be, we can find an optimized solution for it, which can help you to get your desired output, or I should say desired resolution for the problem. So planning is very basic, and it should be taken care that when you are planning, you should take all the scenarios, whatever you are thinking. After that, you have to write those things on a code that we are going to learn today in the PictoBlocks. So after once you write those things, you have to test and debug also. So what exactly it means, testing and debugging? So if I explain you about testing and debugging, so once you have planned a solution for a problem, you have written the codes. After that, you have to test that how exactly it is working, whether it is giving you the desired output or not, or is it working perfectly or not. And after that, if you find a perfect solution, then no worries. But if you don't find an optimized solution, in that case, you have to find the error. And finding an error, that what we call as debugging. So there might be chances that you might have used some different blocks, or you might have misplaced the blocks, or I should say misplaced some of the codes, which is giving you an error. But after debugging, you will get your desired output. For all of these, we have brought up a PictoBlocks that is the fastest way to learn coding and artificial intelligence. The most important thing on the PictoBlocks is you can work with it on your laptop, desktops, PCs, also on your, smartphones. You can make stories, games, animations, and make AI ML projects. And also you can program a wonderful robots. So these are some examples you can see on the screen, which have been completed by some of the students. So like you can make a small story or animation within the PictoBlocks, or you can also make the wonderful games. You can also program different robots you can see on the screen. And all these things are so easy to do with a block coding on the PictoBlocks that you are going to really enjoy this part of learning. So I would just request Charlene to please share the PictoBlocks links for their laptop PCs and the application for their Androids. So we will be sharing you the links which will help you to download the PictoBlocks in your laptops, PC, whatever you are using. Or if you want to work on Android phones, you can use the Android application.
Yes, students, please hold on. Like, sir is facing an issue. So please don't worry. Sir will going to come soon. Don't worry about it. I have already shared you the link, right? So from there, you can directly install the PictoBlocks for your laptop and for your Android and smartphones, right? So what is a PictoBlocks is basically the Scratch based programming, right? Where it's supposed to drag and drop functionality. Yes, so Ayush sir is here.
Yeah. So sorry, students, actually, due to some stormy weather around my place, there was a disconnection of internet and I was just got disconnected. Not a problem. We'll start from where we left. So I'll just share my screen back and take you to the. Yeah, so I think now my voice is audible. So can you please share your response on the chat box? Okay. So can you please share your response on the chat box? Am I audible? Okay, wonderful. So I have started getting, we can hear you. Thanks, sister. So I'll just share my screen back. Yeah, so I think till now you might have got the links for the PictoBlocks to be downloaded in your laptop, PCs, or in your Android phones. Now, if you want, you can do the things along with me, not a problem. We will be taking your doubts and we'll be taking care of every problem you are coming along and we'll try to resolve every problem. But also I will request you to first follow the steps, what we are trying to show you and tell you the concepts, okay? So what exactly is PictoBlocks? So PictoBlocks is a Scratch-based graphical programming software, which give you a friendly interface with drag and drop facility and make wonderful codings and projects. So I will be explaining you these parts in detail while showing the things in the PictoBlocks. But for as of now, you can see this is an interface, how exactly PictoBlocks look like on the. Okay, so this is how exactly PictoBlocks look like when you start up in your laptops or desktops. So here you can see there are blocks, there is a scripting area, stage, sprite, extensions. So we will be talking about all of these. So let me just stop my share and take you to the PictoBlocks and start understanding the concepts from there. So just give me a moment. So I can see some of you are replying on the chat. So sir, I know how to do the Scratch. So it's wonderful to know that if you know how to do a Scratch, things are going to be very easy for you because PictoBlocks is a Scratch-based programming platform, but with a wonderful different, solutions of artificial intelligence and machine learning. Yeah, so here we are. So I'll just share my screen back and show you up the interface of the PictoBlocks. So yeah, so I hope my PictoBlocks screen is visible to everyone. Yeah, Charlene, is it visible? Yeah, hello, Charlene.
Yes, it is visible.
Wonderful. So yeah. Students who know about PictoBlocks, it's really wonderful, but who don't know, let me like give you a little glance over the what are the things on the PictoBlocks are and how we can work it out. And we will be going in the depth of artificial intelligence and machine learning also. But let's start with a very basic so that, as I say, we are going to learn the Scratch of PictoBlocks, very basics of PictoBlocks. So now on the screen, the most attractive thing which you can see on you, which will be like attracting you, is the teddy bear. So every sprite on the PictoBlocks, every character on the PictoBlocks is called as in Sprite. We have a dedicated library to which we can select any sprites. So let me just show up this. So you can see this is a dedicated library, which can be from where you can choose a different sprites. Also, there are multiple options in the software in your PictoBlocks when you are using it in your laptop that you can paint it. You can paint your sprite. You can upload your own sprite. Now, let's come to the second point, which you can see where exactly this sprite is standing. So the name of the sprite is Toby. So I'll now start calling it a Toby. Okay, so we can see there is a white background where the Toby is standing, and we called it as a stage. So we can change the background of the stage by choosing a backdrop. So again, PictoBlocks comes up with a wonderful library of a backdrop. So you can just click on choose a backdrop, and you can choose a backdrop from the library. Although I'll just choose the beach backdrop. Okay. Now on the center, the white area, you can see we called it as a scripting area because we will be making the scripts using the blocks on the left hand side. So yeah, so these are the different blocks. And along with that, you can see there are different palettes like motion palette, look palette, sound palette, event palette, and many more. We will be telling you more about different palettes and the extensions in the coming. But to start with, let me show you some of the blocks related to the motion palette. So here, you can see there is a dedicated color. You can see it a blue. So motion palette colors is a blue. So you can see all the blocks in the blue, which are related to the motion palette. Along with that, you can see different tabs over the palettes. One is costume and the sound. So yeah, so you can use the different costumes of a same sprite to make an animation, and also use a sound library, which comes up with the PictoBlocks to provide a sound effect in your project. Now to start with very basic activity, let's start with an activity of animating a sprite. So to start with animation of a sprite, you, as I said, there will be three steps while we are doing a coding, or I should say while we are doing a programming. So there should be a planning that what exactly I want to make. So if I talk about planning, so we have to plan that what is the last output we want to take from this project. So if I talk about the project, so it is an animation. So at the last, I want that my Toby should be moving on the beach, right? So if I talk about moving, or I should say, if I talk about the movement, so yeah, you can see the motion palette, and we will be using the blocks from the motion palette. So here, if I bring the first block, that is move 10 steps, if I'm going to click here, you can see the Toby has started moving. But the problem comes up here that how many times I have to press this. So we have a control palette by which we can control the different blocks. Like if I take this forever. So if I explain you this forever block, what exactly it is used for. So if I'm going to put any of the blocks inside this forever, this is going to be repeated until I stop it. So if I just click on forever, you can see that my Toby has started taking the 10 steps. Again, even if I'm bringing it back, it is again and again taking the steps in the forward direction. If I want to stop it, I have to press the stop button on the top of the stage. So now, student, so this was the first part, what I wanted to see, that it should be moving. But again, the problems comes up here is that I wanted that my Toby should go till the end and come back to its initial position. How can I get it? So students, if I want to make something where I want it should be, the motion should be to and fro and it should go and come back, there I have to choose a set a rotation style. Okay, so this is going to set a rotation style. Also, I will be choosing a block if on edge bounce. So this is going to bring my sprite back to the initial position. So let's check. So I'll add one block at a time so that you can understand it's working very easily. So I'm adding if on edge bounds inside a forever. And let's see how exactly it works. So here you can see, students, it went on the same direction, but the problem comes up here is that it is with a rotation of like complete one rotation, right? So how can I manage that? So as I said, we can manage the rotation style using the block, which is set rotation style left to right. There are multiple options here, that is don't rotate all around. So you can test and try what exactly, how exactly it look like. So if I'll say don't rotate, and I'll just set this rotation style, so you will see my Toby is going till the end and coming back without any rotation. But of course, I need a rotation which should look like that my Toby is moving from left to right. So I'll just click on left to right and keep this above the forever. Here, once I set the rotation style for my sprite, it will be set up and you don't have to put it again in a forever. So now if I'm going to click here, you can see that my Toby is moving from one end to another, but again, there is a short problem, right? So what exactly it is? So what I exactly planned for was that my Toby should move on the beach, right? It should walk on the beach, I should say. But right now it is moreover looking like it is sliding, or I should say it's gliding on the beach. So to bring the animation here, students, we have an option of costumes. So to show you a small demo, I'll just go to costume and I want your focus on the stage on the Toby. So you can see there are different costumes. So what exactly are costumes? So costumes are nothing but the different images of a same sprite. So now you can see if I select Toby walking one, so how exactly this image look like? If I select Toby walking two, you can see how exactly it look like. If I choose this, so you can see now the mouth of the Toby is closed. And if I choose this, the mouth of the Toby, you can see the legs has just went apart. So these are the different pictures which we say as in costume. And just by choosing different costumes at a time, after a certain time, we can make an animation. To show you here, just see if I'm going to choose between two costume, so you can see it is looking like my Toby is talking to me, right? But this is definitely, we don't want to change it with my cursor. That's why we are learning the coding. How can I do it using the blocks? So in the looks palette, students, you're gonna find a switch costume block. And what exactly it is going to do is, it is going to change the costume of the Toby. So what I'm going to select here is Toby walking one, and I'll put it here. And along with this, I'll just duplicate this. And how exactly I did, I just right-clicked on the block and duplicated the same block. And I'll change it to Toby walking two. I'll keep these two blocks just below each other. And let's see whether it works or not. So you will not see that what I expected, definitely that didn't happen. And why it didn't happen? So here, students, the concept here is like it is changing the costume. It is changing the costume from Toby walking one to Toby walking two, but it is working in a such a high speed that we are not able to see it from our normal eyes, right? So here the concept of a weight block comes in. So in the control, you will see there is a block which says weight. So we are going to use this weight block just after once the costume is changed. And also we want there should be a movement going on when there is a change in costume. So after once I have, like you can see, I have added one weight just behind, just below the costume. I'll just click it on here. And now you can see it is looking like my Toby is walking on the beach. So I'm certainly getting what I desired for. And yeah, so I'll just stop this. Also, if I want to increase the speed of the Toby, how can I do it? I can change the wait time over here. So I'll just select 0.5 and the wait 0.5 second, that is a half second. I'm here a 0.5 second. And let me just click this script again. So now you can see it is looking like Toby is walking. Along with this, if I want to if I want now that my Toby should also move on the beach and also say hello to everyone, so what I can do is I can go to looks and I can break a save block, and I have, this is a text area where I have written hello, and I'll add it on the top. Now let's see how exactly it is working. So now you can see my Toby is walking on the beach, also saying hello to everyone. You can customize this thing just by adding different sounds and different things you want to add. But is this completed? No, definitely not. Because there is an option, students, to go into the full screen mode into the picture blocks on the right hand side top corner. You can see this is a full screen control. And till now you have seen me that I have been clicking over the script to run the blocks, right? But what if I go to the full screen mode? So here, students, I won't be getting a chance to click on the script. So I have to activate this green flag. And how can I do it? So in the event palette, you will find a block which says when green flag is clicked. And just putting this on the top makes complete my program for this desired output that I wanted, basically, that my Toby should move. So if I'm going to click now on this green flag, so now you can see my Toby is walking on the beach with saying hello to everyone. But on the full screen, you might be little curious to know what are the different different buttons over the top. So here you can record the video of your project. You can take the snapshot, and this option will open the gallery where exactly these videos and screenshots are getting saved. So this was like a short animation program for you all to let you get started with very basics of PictoBlocks, because we will be going in depth of the things in the coming time. But this was like a short program to give you a little understanding of the basics of the PictoBlocks. So I'll just stop my share for as of now. If you have any questions, I and Charlene sir will be very much happy to answer your all questions. So what is the mic option is for? So let me just share my screen and show you that again. So yeah, so if I just share you here, so you were asking about the mic. So as I said, this is also going to open your gallery, and it will show where exactly these videos are getting saved. Okay, so I'll just stop my share and let me take your questions. So me and Charlene will be very much happy to answer all your answers. So yeah, Aradhya, thanks for your appreciation. We can see this is very interesting. Okay, wonderful. How to change a backdrop? So we will be sharing you the recorded sessions, not a problem, students. Okay, although I'll just answer your question. So you can select backdrop in the PictoBlocks so now I think the PictoBlocks screen will be much more visible. So here you can see choose a backdrop option. Okay, so I think now it will be very much clear to everyone. Although we are going to also show you a mobile interface, so if you want to work with your Android mobiles, how you can do that, we are also going to tell you about that. So let me share back my screen and show you the mobile interface as well. Okay, so if I talk about mobile interface, student, once you have downloaded the PictoBlocks, you will be seeing some buttons over here. So you might be seeing a plus button and a play button. So what exactly it is for? Play button is resuming the project you were in, while the plus button is for initiating a new project. So once, for the first timers, when you are going to switch on the PictoBlocks, you will see the plus button. When you are going to click it on, you will see a interface something like this. And I'll explain you the same things which I have explained in the the desktop interface. I'll just explain you here some of the things. On the top, students, you can see a purple line, purple bar where the PictoBlocks is written, and we called it as a menu bar. So you can see there are three options: select a backdrop, add a sprite, and a selected sprite. So if you want to add a backdrop from the backdrop library into the PictoBlocks, you have to just click on that backdrop option. An edit option will come up over here, and you have to click it there. And after once, when you will reach to the backdrop library, you can select the backdrop of your choice. You can see a stage, a sprite over here. This is the scripting area. And you can see green flag, a full screen option, and on the right hand side top bottom corner. You can also hide and show the stage. So you can see an option over here which will enable you to hide and show the stage. If you want to go back, how can you do that? So you have a back button just beside the PictoBlocks written over the menu bar. You have to click on that and you will be just getting back. So if I talk about the different components which we have talked about, is a stage. So you know what exactly it is: stage palette, sprite palette, block palette, scripting area, and menu bar. So just to give you a short recap. So this is a stage. We have talked about it, where the sprite was standing. This is a stage palette. Here you can see your sprites, which you have taken for your programming. Here you can see the blocks palette, and different palettes have a different dedicated blocks related to it. Script. So the program which we are doing within blocks, we called it in a script, and we do it all together in the scripting area. So I'll just stop my share over here. And if you have any questions, me along with Shalin will be very much happy to answer them all. Yeah, sure, you will be getting the links. Don't worry about it. If you have any questions, so on the Android, to check the background option, it is on the menu bar. The first option is of backdrop. You have to click on that option. Edit button will come up. You can see a pencil button. It looks like a little pencil. You have to click on it and you will find an option to upload your to check your backdrop. So here I can see Karthik Divakar has said someone you can use MIT Scratch. So yeah, you can. So basically Scratch, the Scratch is a different platform. So this is a PictoBlocks, and we think that PictoBlocks is much more better than Scratch, and you can do so many different things and wonderful things of artificial intelligence and machine learning in the PictoBlocks. So we would recommend you to use the PictoBlocks, and we will be also explaining you about the very important thing, that is the competition, during this week. So let me just give you some answers. I can see there is a little confusion in uploading a backdrop in the smartphone, right? So I'll just share my screen back and let me show you it here. So now students, you can see if you want to choose a backdrop in the phone. So on the top, you can see the first option in the smartphone is a backdrop. And here you can see this edit option. Once you will be clicking it on, you will see a backdrop settings. And at the bottom, you will see a button which is an add backdrop. And once you will click it here, you will be able to see the wonderful library of backdrop, and you can do it very easily. So if you have any other questions, you can feel free to ask. I think, yeah, of course, Arnagor, it's upon you. You can choose any time you want on the weight block. It should be like just looking good, right? Okay. So now taking you forward towards like telling you more about the competition. So we have came up with one competition for you all. So along with this 3-day webinar series, that today is the first part, and in the coming 2 days, we will be learning about artificial intelligence and machine learning in the PictoBlocks. We have brought a wonderful competition for you all. So let me just share my screen and tell you more about it. I'm sorry. Okay, so talking about the competition. So along a week-long international online programming contest hosted by Stempedia, we have also brought a competition for you. So what exactly you have to do to be a part of this competition? You have to be present on all the three webinars of artificial intelligence, machine learning concepts to understand these concepts. After that, you have to choose any AI ML extensions of PictoBlocks which are available for you to bring up a wonderful creation and innovative projects. And you have to submit that projects on the links which we will be sharing with you. So last date of submission for your project will be 23rd of May. And what exactly you are going to win? So you can see this is a Quirky Innovator Kit developed by Stempedia. So winner will be rewarded with the Quirky Innovator Kit, and all the participants who will be attending all the three webinars and also submitting their final projects will be awarded with the certificates. Okay, so also I would like to tell you that in the coming two webinars, we are going to learn about artificial intelligence and machine learning, and also going to make a wonderful activity of face expression detector and mask detector. From here, I would like to ask Jennifer to tell and motivate you more about the prizes and the things. Yeah, over to you, Jennifer.
Am I audible now?
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Mr. Ayush, for such a wonderful experience. I hope everyone would have got a decent idea about block-based programming and PictoBlocks from this session. Thank you for covering the user interface of PictoBlocks and methods of creating animations in detail. As you must be aware by now that we don't want to preach just theory to you. We want you to apply by making projects of your own and submit them to the competition. And as Mr. Ayush mentioned, the winners will receive an exciting AI and robotics kit, Quirky. I would like to play a short video for you so that we can have a better idea what Quirky is.
Meet Quirky. It's a gesture-controlled robot. No. A smart gardening system? No, wait. An autonomous delivery truck? No. A Mars rover? Actually, it's all this rolled into one.
Hi, Quirky.
Hi, Jack.
It's an AI and robotics learning companion for the next generation. Quirky takes children on an exciting journey to explore advanced concepts on AI and robotics with an easy, engaging, and hands-on approach. It is packed with interactive online courses and engaging live sessions that help children to learn, code, and make their own real-world projects. In other words, one Quirky, endless possibilities. Quirky is portable. Carry Quirky around and control it using your laptop, tablet, or even a smartphone. It's easy to program, whether you're a coding newbie using Blocks or an expert using Python. Comes with a plug-and-play interface, making it hassle-free, and with some of the coolest latest tech. So imagine a self-driving car, which identifies street signs and pedestrians, or a faithful robot dog that follows commands with the help of machine learning and object detection. It's evident that Quirky is for everyone who wants to be ahead of the curve.
Ready to explore the universe of AI and robotics with me?
I hope the video was very exciting to you. Let me take a few minutes to talk about Quirky. Quirky is a programmable AI robot kit that allows you to bring your code to life. It's a pocket-sized board to help you make a variety of artificial intelligence and machine learning projects, from self-driving car Yeah, can you move a little bit downwards? From self-driving car to waste collectors, from weather monitoring systems to expression replicators and whatnot. And you can make these wonders from the comfort of your home. We will be launching Quirky globally on Kickstarter soon. And we want you to have the maximum benefits from the same. And to ensure that, we are inviting you for joining the day one VIP list. You can join the same by registering yourself at the link given in the chat box now. With this, day one of the learning from scratch ends here. I'd like to thank all of you for joining and would like to thank our presenters, Mr. Ayush and Mr. Shaling, for sharing the knowledge. See you tomorrow.
So I'll just before ending the webinar, I'd like to take some of the questions from the students. So some of them are where to send the project. So students, we will be sharing you the link, okay? And in that link, basically you will be submitting your details and the project, okay? And yeah, how can you download this PictoBlock? So we have already shared you the links. Again, we'll share you the link with you. So what we can do is we'll stop the chat for as of now so that you can take all the links with you. So just let me paste some of the links. So students, these are the two links for downloading basically the PictoBlocks in your laptop PCs, desktops, and if you are using an Android phone. Also, we will be sharing you the link for sending the project soon. And yeah, hope you have enjoyed the session, you have liked the session, and we would love to see you tomorrow back again at the same time. Thank you all for joining. Bye-bye. Happy Scratch Week.